There's a list in my phone called shit that I think is true but isn't true. Hey there, Coach Devin here. Let's talk about bad headspaces. Now, one thing I follow a lot of on social media is fitness influencers, and quite often those influencers love to talk about how they were struggling but now they're not. I got no problem with that. The problem is a lot of them, they're doing it all the time. It's like every day. So we're going to talk about that here in a second and how to get out of a bad headspace. I'm going to tell you some stories about me and some of the things I've struggled with in the past. Before we get going, hit that like and subscribe down below. Please share this with your friends. The reason I make these videos is I'm hoping to pass on some information and some knowledge to you. I've been in the fitness industry now for 28 years. I have been a trainer for a long, long time, obviously. I've owned a gym for 11 years. I've made pretty much every mistake you can make when it comes to health and fitness. I've seen a lot of mistakes. So my goal on this is to pass out good, honest, real information, not the crap you see out there online. So please share this with your friends, subscribe and like it. And let me know at the end of this video, write out a comment. What's a pet peeve of yours for people, and how do you get yourself out of a negative headspace? All right, so let's talk a little bit about negative headspaces. I tend to be a fairly positive guy. For the most part, I consider myself pretty positive. I push myself to be positive. However, there are times that I get myself into a negative headspace. And you know what? You can get in there pretty easily. And I don't want to be one of those trainers that's, you know, like I said, long posts on Instagram about how, you know, I was in a terrible spot, but now I'm in a better spot. And they're writing that crap like every third day. They were struggling, but now they're not. And I'm like, how many times are you going to struggle, dude? That stuff drives me nuts. But let's talk about real stuff in this. And I'm not going to get into, you know, telling everything about my life history, because you don't want to hear too much about it. But I will say this. I can get infatuated with things and hyper-focused. It's not good. I have some ADHD. Didn't think I did until I was probably in my late 30s, and I had a client that was a psychologist, and he made a comment about me having ADHD, and I was like, what are you talking about? I don't have ADHD. And he sent me later a one sheet of things that if you had ADHD, this is some adult ADHD symptoms. I had everything on that list. But one of the things that struck me was the need to hyper focus on things. That's something I have. I hyper focus on stuff. So if it's good, bad, indifferent, whatever, when I'm focused, it's laser in. I can't see anything else. I can't see around corners. I am 100% into something. Now that can be great. When it comes to exercise, I will grind like nobody's business because I don't want to stop. And I'm like, do it. You must do it. I get up in the morning, exhausted, don't care, gonna work out. Like, that's my mindset. Get a little of that from my mom. My mom's a hard worker and was a very hard worker. And my dad's a hard worker, so I got some of that, honestly. But the laser focus side, that's all me. And it can be good in a lot of ways. Like I said, when I am focused on something positive, it's great. When I focus on something negative, it's not good, because it just rolls and rolls and rolls, and I cannot stop focusing. It's hard. It can be hard. So what do you do about that when it comes to health and fitness? If you can't stop hyper-focusing on junk food, or can't stop focusing on how hard the workout will be, or you can't stop focusing on how, you know, your spouse is annoying you, or how someone's talking to your spouse and you feel jealous. How do you handle that stuff? I can tell you from personal experience, I find this stuff hard. It is hard to get yourself out of a negative headspace. But one thing I have found to get myself out of a negative headspace and to break away is, believe it or not, YouTube videos on positivity and motivation. I'm not kidding. When I get into a bad headspace and I recognize it, because one of the things quite often for me that happens, I get hyper-focused, I don't see anything else, I'm just 100 miles an hour on that thing, and then guess what? I don't even realize I'm hyper-focused and I'm becoming negative when I'm not a negative guy for the most part. And it takes sometimes somebody pointing it out to me or me pointing it out to myself and going, holy shit, what is happening here? Stop it. You know what, when you have that moment, what I do, and I go back to the basics of needing to hear something repeatedly. I need to hear something else to drive my mind in that direction. So there's two things I like to do. The first one is YouTube videos. I listen to YouTube videos on motivation and positivity. Anything motivating and positive helps. And the nice thing about them, there's 8 million YouTube videos. There's probably actually more. But there's a lot of YouTube videos out there about how to be more positive, people talking about being positive, people being motivating. There's a ton of that stuff out there. It's free. Use it. I'll get in the car and listen to them. I listen to them at home when I'm folding clothes. Anything to get my mind in that headspace of, I am going to be great. This is going to be awesome. Get your butt up and get going. Be positive. Don't think on negative things. That really helps. It has helped me in the past. If I am down or stressed about something, that has always helped me move forward past that and get myself into another spot. So you need that consistently being pounded of, hey, you know what? Positive things are happening. Here are some positive things. Go do it. Listening and being inundated with positive thought. It's very hard to be negative when someone's telling you positive things. It's tough. And you know what? That's what you want. That's what I want. I want it to be so hard that I have to be positive because I'm like, well, you know, I keep listening to positive stuff. It will rub off on you. It's basically forcing yourself to be positive and motivated through osmosis. I think personally, everybody should do it every day. 100% you should do it. Now, the second thing I do is I write up lists, and this is fairly recent for me, but I write up lists of things that I've created in my head that aren't real. I have a list in my phone. It's called shit that I think is true that isn't true. I'm not kidding. There's a list in my phone called shit that I think is true but isn't true. And you know what? I add to that list every single day because I have a fairly vivid imagination. I will create a scenario in my mind sometimes when I'm brushing my teeth or shaving or whatever, and then it will start to spiral. If it's a positive scenario, then I will think positively, positively, positively. If it's a negative one, I will create it and it will turn into like it's real. I'm not kidding. It feels real to me. And that's because that's how strong your mind is and your imagination is that strong that you can make something real. If you're thinking that, you know, man, everything's bad, work sucks, and my boss is about to fire me, you will create a scenario built all around that, if you're me, and then next thing you know, you feel like crap, and you actually believe the things that you're thinking in your mind. Or you think that, you know, somebody hates your guts that doesn't really hate you. They probably don't even care what you have to say, but you're creating that in your mind because you're thinking about it, and you think, that person hates me, I know they hate me, you know, and all those things that go on. When you start creating those things in your head, I have found, and this is, again, this is fairly recent for me. It's new to put this together, but I listened to a YouTube video on how to get over and not do dumb stuff. And one of the things they said was make a list of the things that you know isn't real. A list of things that you know aren't real, but you still say them. And I was like, okay, that seems fair. And that, I made that list up. I was like, shit that I think is real that isn't real. That's my list in my phone. And every single time, and I mean every time without fail, I don't care what I'm doing, if as I start to create something in my head that isn't real and is negative, I go in my phone and I write it down. And then I read all the things on that list. And everything on that list I'm not allowed to think about. I'm not allowed to think about anything on that list again. I can't create that scenario anymore. It actually helps. It actually forces you to go, okay, that scenario is not real. And sometimes, I can tell you this, once you get a couple things on that list, and I got a few on there because I have a vivid imagination. Let's be honest, I can create pretty much anything in my head, which is not good and bad. But something that I find interesting about that is once you start reading that through, you know, after you're adding something else to it, like I think, I don't know, whatever, and I add that, you know, point number 6 or 8, and then I go in there and I have to read everything else, I'm like, that shit doesn't sound real. That doesn't sound like something that's reasonable. Most of that stuff sounds stupid. It's like by the light of day, when you're in a better headspace, you realize, hey, that stuff doesn't, there's nothing to it. It's not, that's not real. I've created a scenario that isn't real, but I'm trying to make it real because my brain somehow wants to punish me for something. It's like if you think in your mind that your spouse wants to cheat on you or get together with somebody else. Then you start creating scenarios around that saying, you know, oh my God, this person, I saw her like something of an ex, or the ex is, you know, like something of hers, therefore they must be talking. And then next thing you know, that scenario turns into something totally different. And you know, listen, we've all done this at some point. I don't think I'm alone. I could be alone, it's possible, but judging from the stuff I've read online, that is not, it's normal. That stuff happens, but you know what, when you write that down and it's in point form right there in front of you, quite often you look at it and you go, doesn't make any sense. No, that person doesn't dislike me. No, my spouse is not cheating on me. No, my kids don't hate my guts. No, my coworkers don't think I'm a jackass. Those things start to become different. And this is putting you in a virtuous cycle not a negative headspace and not a vicious cycle anymore, because it's a positive cycle. You start going, okay, wait a minute, that's not true and that's not true and that's not true. This is a bunch of stuff, and that's why I named it shit that I think is true that isn't true, because it's not true. And you got to keep that in mind. And then when I read it, I realize, hey, it's not true. So listen, two things: watch positive motivational YouTube videos and write down stuff that you're creating in your mind right there that isn't real, and you will feel a lot better. I promise. Listen, it's worked for me. If it worked for me, I promise it'll work for you. Let me know right up in the comments if you have other ideas and ways to get yourself in a better headspace. I would love to hear them, because I love everything like that. Have yourself an amazing day, everybody, and don't fight the awesome.